Greetings, people of internet! My name is Ivan Mandić, but you may call me Ivan. Welcome to the 8th Nucleotide Game Development Diary. This development diary covers the progress of the game Nucleotide. Each episode number corresponds to the number of development weeks that are behind us. In the last development diary, I showed you real-time water surface physics. That demo was showing a red ball floating in a small pool of water. This week, I continued to work on the same algorithm, and my goal was to enable water surface physics for infinitely large surfaces. That might sound insane, but it's doable. As you can see, our green cube is moving water around, and so are the other floating objects. This was one of the most challenging things I had to do so far, since I wasn't able to multiply the same water surface to get the required size, because that would kill pretty much any CPU in the world. Moving the same algorithm to the GPU would be almost as equally bad for the game, because it would require DirectX 11, and a lot of people aren't ready for it. Scaling the same water surface mesh would kill all the details, and that option was out of the question. It took me 6 days to figure this out, but it's working right now and I'm really satisfied. I'm not completely done yet, but the progress is obvious. I have few more ideas on how to make this run faster and look better, but that will require some additional time. One thing that I didn't show, since it's not completely done yet, is that I can actually zoom out the camera and everything will run fine, but you will be able to see that in one of the future development diaries.
So, did you like this video? Yes? Then click the like button and share it with your friends, maybe they will like it as well, you never know. If you have any questions, thoughts or suggestions, you can leave them in the comment section. Subscribe if you are not subscribed, because we create at least one video every week. Thank you for watching, see you soon, bye!